Are you thirsty?
You must be very thirsty.
You only take milk with your coffee.
Coffee with milk, that's all.
Who are you?
My name is Becky.
What are you doing here?
My name is Becky.
Anna's friend?
My name is Becky.
After your throat is quenched, you must do what you must do.
Take a sip of coffee and go.
Zach, this case looks like it's directly related to us. I do not know how yet, but I do know I need some coffee.
George said he'd have someone pick us up in the parking lot. Let's get some breakfast with Polly first.
Whoa there!
Did you need something?
No, I was just passing by. I didn't think anybody else was here other than Polly. The door opening like that just... it surprised me, that's all. I'm Kaysen, Forrest Kaysen. Nice to meet you. I travel a whole lot, you see, selling tree saplings. Just the usual salesman doing the usual road trip. Sometimes I feel, I don't know, like a jolly old bumblebee spreading pollen.
FBI Special Agent Francis York Morgan.
I get it. You're the special agent Scarface that everyone's yakking about. Nice to meet you, Francis.
Special Agent Scarface? I'd need a bigger scar to live up to that name. Call me York. That's what everyone calls me.
What? You got it. York.
Is this your first visit here, then?
No, sir. Actually, I've been coming here once or twice a year for, a while now. I don't get much business here, but it sure does make a fine vacation. I mean, it's a gorgeous hotel at a bargain price. It's so relaxing in these parts, too. Oh, I just love all the nature. I feel so relaxed here. Say hi to Willie. Oh, don't worry. He's a good boy. Do you like dogs?
Hey, Willie. How are you doing?
He's pretty smart, too. Oops. Before I forget, let me give you this. It's just a sample of what I sell.
Thank you. How kind of you.
So, what brings the old FBI out here? Sounds like more than just a vacation.
A murder, actually. The perpetrator is still out there. Try to stay indoors at night and during the rain. We want to prevent it from happening again, okay?
Oh, it's a darn shame. Places like this used to be the safest in America.
Could I ask you something? Do you know a lot about seeds?
Seeds? Gardening, huh? You don't look like a green thumb, but let me tell you, though. I'm pretty much the only one who can make those saplings sprout. And there's a trick to it that can't really be passed on, you know? It's like the only secret of making a good smoked ham, something like that. But, you know, once they sprout, you don't need to do much. You can leave it be, and why, it'll turn into a big tree no matter what happens. Kind of like those stocks that politicians buy that just keep growing and growing. Well, you just wait and see. This town is gonna love them. Right. We were just about to go take a morning stroll, so I'll get going. Good luck now with that case.
Thanks.
Zach, do you remember what the coffee said? Forrest Kaysen. F.K.
This show has just begun.
Hey, York.
Willie, how are you doing, boy?
Hey, Willie, wait! Where are you going?
You got me, Kaysen. Willie just ran off with some bones I was carrying as evidence.
Bones?
I can't really go into the details, but I need them.
York, that's not good. Willie loves bones. He's a dog. And carrying bones around with him is like, well, like throwing a blonde in a bikini into a boy's locker room. It's almost like you were asking for trouble. Sorry, but you're just gonna have to forget about your bones. I better run after him now. I'll see you later.
Forget about them. If I gave up that easily, then I wouldn't be a good federal agent, would I, Zack? We're going to have to search his house, Zack. Let's get back those precious bones. Breakfast looks as good as yesterday's.
I hope you enjoy it.
I will, and thank you. I just met Kaysen, actually.
Oh, good old Mr. Kaysen. Did he give you a sapling?
As a matter of fact, he did. Don't tell me he gives one to everyone he meets.
No. Only to the people he feels comfortable with. He told me. He must feel really comfortable with me.
He must. Is there anyone he hasn't given a sapling to?
Mustard? Okay, I'll just get it from the kitchen then.
No, mustard has nothing to do with it. I was wondering if you know of anyone that Kaysen didn't give a sapling to.
Oh, too much pepper. I did think it might be. I'm sorry.
Ah, Zack, I forgot. We'll never get anything out of her, will we? Forrest Kaysen. He's hiding something. You think so too, right, Zack? But no need to rush. All secrets are hidden until they are inevitably divulged. The powers of entropy. The world exposes everything and causes chaos. Just like this coffee. Garlic. I'd like to eat some, but it might damage my chances of getting information from anyone. People would just turn away. I can hardly believe this result. Amazing! This is more than fortune. This is advice from the divine optimist himself. Not only does it taste great, but it also tells me so much. Coffee is truly the greatest drink known to man. Thank you.
Oh, hi.
What's wrong, Polly? You look a little tired.
I'm fine. Well, it's just that I was cleaning up my room, and so many memories came flooding back to me.
Memories?
Oh, my dear! Mr. Morgan, that's not the kind of question you should ask a lady.
Good morning, Agent Morgan. Did you sleep well?
Morning, George. Dreamland was quite nice.
You do look well rested.
Oh, I was up practically all night doing paperwork.
Thomas helped me out, so I was able to go home and get some sleep, but not enough.
Diane got back into town late last night. We should give her a visit.
Which means going to the art gallery, correct?
She lives and works in the office there. So it's the only place to find her. The gallery is open from 10 to 1700.
Time for some art appreciation. A cultural activity in such a small countryside town. Amazing, Zach.
The gallery is called Muses Gallery. The Muses were the nine daughters of the goddess of memory in Greek mythology.
Ah, it's just like Diane to name it that way.
Is she that intelligent a woman?
Oh, maybe. You'll see for yourself soon enough.
Did you see how Emily reacted, Zach? I sense that this Diane is not popular among other women. I can't wait to meet her.
The gallery is on the north side of town. Take the road along the lake and go north.
Such a small town. Am I prejudiced to think that it doesn't seem to fit?
Greenvale and every small town has every right to enjoy art.
That's right. Small towns tend to be full of highly cultured people. Although, I can't say I've been to the gallery myself.
George, what about you? Are you into art?
Actually, yes. I like going to the gallery. It's really relaxing.
Some people just have sides to them that you'd never expect. By the way, about Diane, again, is she the type that isn't very appreciated by other women?
What do you mean?
Exactly what it sounds like, Emily. Is she very attractive, especially to the opposite sex?
So you're asking if she's sexy, right?
Well, she does always wear high heels.
And definitely, it's hard to explain.
That must be because sex appeal has no effect on you.
Now that's out of line.
I'm sorry, Emily, I didn't mean to poke fun at you. You just reacted so strongly to Diane's name.
I did not. It's like you're suggesting I'm the total opposite of her, is that it?
That's not what anyone is suggesting. Let's just drop this conversation, okay?
looks more like an old mansion than an art gallery.
Diane liked the building so much she turned it into an art gallery.
She left the exterior untouched and had the insides redone.
So she's rich.
She bought this place, didn't she? Does that answer your question?
Indeed it does. Well, George, Emily, I want to talk with Diane alone. Will you wait here for me?
Don't tell me you still don't trust us.
No, that's not it. But this is very important to me. I always make sure that I meet with the important ones, one-on-one. Otherwise, it's difficult to sense the subtle reactions of the suspect. This is just how I do things, and I'd appreciate your understanding.
But... go on, then. You're not going to listen to us anyway, are you?
You're starting to understand me, George.
Well then, Zach. Let's go and meet Lady Diane. Hello? Hello? No reply. Let's take a look around then, Zach. Hello, Olivia. Do you like art?
Yes. Yes, I do. Well, I mean... I like trees.
Trees. Okay. Ah, but I see because these are all tree paintings. Do you come here often, then?
No. Just sometimes. I'm sorry, I really need to get back to the diner.
Zach, she was lying about something. She said trees, not paintings of trees. She doesn't need to come here to see trees. There's tons of trees outside.
Like I said, there's no point in you having this. I can put it to far better use. I'm taking it with me, okay?
That's fine by me, then. As you wish.
The FBI agent, right? Just wait a moment, please. I'll be right with you.
So there's no way you could have been at the scene of the crime?
That's right. I was drinking at the bar with Nick until early morning. I'm sure if you ask him about it, he'll say the same.
Very well. I'll be sure to do that. One other thing. That argument with Carol just now.
She's always like that. She thinks of me as an enemy. Always bickering at what I say.
Is there any reason for that?
Perhaps because someone she liked ended up with me in my bed?
That would explain it, yes. If I may be so bold, who was the lucky man?
Oh, I sleep with anyone I wish. Anyone I prefer to sleep with. I guess she had her eye on one of them, but I don't know who it was exactly. I could sleep with you, if you like.
I'm flattered by your offer, but I don't think that would be appropriate. You're exactly the kind of woman a man in my job should never get involved with.
Isn't that a shame, darling?
I'll be frank. Right now, you are not a suspect. But both Zach and I are certainly feeling shaky about you.
If you want to remain in the clear, just watch yourself from now on.
Oh, you don't know, do you? Artists and art lovers, we love a good thrill.
Thank you for your help. I have nothing further to ask you at the moment. Goodbye.